This is the closest supernova explosion to Earth. Known as the Vela Supernova, this cataclysmic event happened just 800 light-years away from us. While most supernovae we observe are millions or even billions of light-years away, this one happened close enough that prehistoric humans likely saw it brighten the night sky for weeks. The Vela Supernova Remnant sits in the southern constellation Vela, named after a ship's sail. The explosion occurred about 11,000 years ago, a time when humans were just beginning to develop agriculture and permanent settlements. Imagine early farmers looking up to see a new star suddenly appear in the night sky, growing brighter until it outshone everything except the moon. What makes Vela truly remarkable is its size in our sky. It spans about 8 degrees. That's 16 times wider than the full moon. Yet despite this enormous apparent size, it's challenging to see with the naked eye because its light is spread out over such a large area. And stick around, because we're about to show you how this nearby explosion might have directly affected life on Earth, and why another similar explosion could happen alarmingly close to us in the astronomical near future. So, what exactly happened 11,000 years ago? A massive star, likely 8 to 20 times heavier than our Sun, reached the end of its life. Unlike our relatively modest Sun, massive stars burn through their nuclear fuel at a furious pace. While our Sun will shine steadily for about 10 billion years, these stellar giants exhaust their fuel in just a few million years. A star is essentially a balancing act between two forces, gravity pulling inward and nuclear fusion pushing outward. When a massive star depletes its fuel, that balance catastrophically fails. The core collapses in less than a second, shrinking from a core roughly the size of Earth to a neutron star about 12 miles across. This collapse releases an almost unimaginable amount of energy. The Vela Supernova released more energy in a few seconds than our Sun will produce in its entire 10 billion year lifetime. The outer layers of the star were blasted outward at speeds of millions of miles per hour. Fast forward to today, 11,000 years later. What's left is an expanding bubble of gas spanning over 100 light years across. That's nearly 600 trillion miles. The Vela Remnant consists of an intricate network of glowing filaments composed of elements like hydrogen, oxygen, and sulfur. These filaments are actually the shredded outer layers of the original star, now spread across a volume of space that could fit millions of solar systems. What makes these filaments glow? As the expanding shock wave from the explosion plows into the surrounding interstellar gas, it heats this material to millions of degrees Kelvin, producing X-ray and optical emissions. Different elements glow in different colors: hydrogen in red, oxygen in blue-green, and sulfur in yellow. In 2021, astronomers used the Dark Energy Camera in Chile to capture a breathtaking 1.3 gigapixel image of the remnant, revealing these delicate structures in unprecedented detail. This image showed how the expanding bubble isn't uniform, but varies in brightness and structure as it interacts with the surrounding interstellar medium. Think of it like dropping a stone in a pond, but instead of a uniform ripple, the wave varies depending on the depth and contents of the pond. Some areas of the remnant expand faster than others, creating the complex structures we see today. At the heart of this vast expanding bubble lies something extraordinary: the Vela Pulsar. This is what remains of the core of the original massive star. When the star's core collapsed, it compressed its mass into an incredibly dense object called a neutron star. Imagine taking something with more mass than our Sun and squeezing it into a sphere just 12 miles across. A sugar cube-sized piece of this neutron star would weigh as much as all of humanity combined. This particular neutron star is spinning about 11 times every second, sweeping beams of radiation through space like a cosmic lighthouse. When one of these beams sweeps across Earth, our radio telescopes detect a pulse, hence the name pulsar. The Vela Pulsar was discovered in 1968 and has proven to be one of the most interesting objects of its kind. Astronomers observed something peculiar. Occasionally, the pulsar suddenly speeds up in what astronomers call a glitch. These glitches happen when the superfluid interior of the neutron star shifts, similar to how earthquakes occur when Earth's crust moves. This rapidly spinning stellar corpse isn't just emitting radio waves, it's visible across the electromagnetic spectrum, from radio to gamma rays. Now, for the part I promised earlier, how did this nearby explosion affect Earth? At just 800 light-years away, the Vela supernova was close enough to potentially impact our planet. When a star explodes this close, it showers the surrounding area with high-energy particles called cosmic rays. These cosmic rays can interact with Earth's atmosphere, possibly influencing atmospheric chemistry and cloud formation, though the exact effects on climate are still debated. Some scientists have proposed that nearby supernovae might have affected Earth's weather patterns and possibly even contributed to extinction events in the distant past. There's also evidence that material from supernovae has reached Earth directly. Scientists have found isotopes in deep-sea sediments that could only have been created in supernova explosions. These include iron-60, which has been detected in ocean crust dating back millions of years. The Vela supernova would have increased Earth's exposure to cosmic radiation for a period of time. While 800 light-years is far enough that it wouldn't cause mass extinction, it might have caused slight increases in mutation rates or temporary changes in the atmosphere, such as minor ozone depletion. Perhaps most interestingly, supernova explosions can trigger the formation of new stars and planets. The shockwave from such an explosion compresses nearby gas clouds, potentially causing them to collapse and form new stellar systems. It's possible that our own solar system's formation was triggered by an ancient supernova. So, in a very real sense, these violent stellar deaths lead to new cosmic beginnings. The relatively close distance of the Vela supernova remnant allows scientists to study it in exceptional detail across multiple wavelengths. This helps scientists answer fundamental questions about how stars die, how elements are created and distributed throughout galaxies, and how neutron stars form and evolve. The remnant also provides insights into cosmic ray acceleration. The shock waves from supernova remnants are thought to be primary sources of the cosmic rays that permeate our galaxy. So, Vela can teach us more about the origin of these high-energy particles that constantly bombard Earth. Some studies suggest that supernova remnants like Vela may convert up to 10% of their explosion energy into cosmic rays, making them some of the most efficient natural particle accelerators. Could another star explode this close to us in the near future? The most famous candidate is Betelgeuse, a red supergiant in the constellation Orion, located about 550 light-years away. Betelgeuse made headlines in 2019 when it unexpectedly dimmed, leading some to wonder if it was about to explode. While that particular dimming turned out to be caused by a dust cloud, Betelgeuse is indeed in the final stages of its life. When Betelgeuse does eventually explode, whether that's tomorrow or 100,000 years from now, it will create a spectacle brighter than the full moon, visible even during daylight. For weeks, we will be able to read by its light at night. Another potential nearby supernova candidate includes Antares and Scorpius, about 550 light-years away. Fortunately, astronomers believe a supernova would need to be within about 50 to 100 light-years to pose a serious threat to life on Earth. All of our known candidates are comfortably beyond this danger zone. If a star like the Vela progenitor were to explode at the same distance today, our modern astronomical instruments would capture the event in unprecedented detail, across every wavelength of light. We would learn more from such an event than from all previous supernova observations combined. As we gaze at the intricate filaments of the Vela remnant today, we're looking at the aftermath of a cosmic cataclysm that our ancestors may have witnessed with their own eyes. It's a reminder that the universe is not static, but constantly changing, with stars being born and dying in spectacular fashion. Don't forget to watch the video on the right and subscribe. Thanks for being part of Cosmoknowledge.